Okay, so I did manage to get my spacecraft, there it is there, in the dark, into an orbit around the moon. You can see that here. If I speed up time, you'll see my spacecraft happily going around the moon. The moon going around Kerbal. So, now that we are at the moon, spacecraft in the dark. There's the big dark moon. It's time to get back home. Kerbal is way over there. Luckily, I have enough fuel, I think, to get back. So, to do that, we go to the map, and we see all our orbits planned out here. I have already planned a maneuver at this point that will launch us, as you see, away from the moon. And then, as we leave the moon, we will get captured in purple here, in an orbit around Kerbal. The periapsis over there, only 2 million meters away, should be close enough that we can slow down and grab into Kerbal. So let's give this a try. We have to wait for 2 hours and 41 minutes until our spacecraft comes around to this spot. So before that happens, I want to aim my spacecraft. And this blue dot here, this blue marker, means the direction I need to face for the maneuver mode that I created. So get right onto that dot. There we go. Now the spacecraft is faced in the right direction. We just need to wait 2 hours, so we're going to speed up time a little bit. 5 times faster, 10 times faster, 50 times faster, 100 times faster, and now we see the time is going down faster. 2 hours, 54 minutes, 55 minutes. Hey, it's going up. Oh, we passed it. Right, so once we get around the back end of the orbit, it'll start going down. Same spot, we're going to add a maneuver. There we go. Zoom out a bit. So we're going to speed up a little bit, and you see the brown dots are what's going to happen to us. So move this maneuver mode a little sooner. Hello, there we go. I am leaving Bun orbit and going back home. There we go. Wait a seat. Excuse me, I sneezed. Okay, so now we can see what will happen. That's a pretty big orbit around Kerbal. I don't want to be that far from Kerbal. So we're going to adjust our maneuver node. Just so. Let's see. Where's the best one to get closest we can to Kerbal? Right about there. 3 million miles. Well, that's still a lot, isn't it? Tony is the least amount of fuel to leave moon orbit. So let's see. It looks like that's about the spot there. So we're going to do a maneuver, and it's going to get us within 3 million miles of Kerbal. Okay, that'll have to do. And the maneuver's over here. So first thing we do, remember, is we re-aim ourselves to the blue marker, so that our spaceship is pointed in the right direction. Now we have to wait 51 minutes. And right now you see my engines are off. There's no engines going on. I'm just aiming it. And the command module has enough gyros in it to maneuver very slowly. Okay, now we're pointed in the right direction. You see, we're kind of pointed at Kerbal, but not exactly. So now we're going to speed up time a little bit. 5 times faster. 10 times faster. And you see the clock now is counting down. 50 minutes. 49 minutes. We're going to go a little faster than that. 48, 47, 46, 45. So we're going to get ready to burn our rockets. That's what's going to happen when we get to this maneuver node. The maneuver node itself doesn't do anything, it just tells us what we should do. And it's telling us when we get there, and you see, this is us here, and we're slowly going around the moon. So when we get to that spot, we're going to do a maneuver node. This brown shows what's going to happen to us in relation to the moon, and the purple shows what happens to us in relation to Kerbal. Because the moon is going around Kerbal, these two are different frames of references, so they look completely different. And we're not actually going to go on two paths. We're only going to go on one path. It's a little confusing. Once you get the idea of frames of reference, it makes a little more sense. It takes some practice. So let's go back to our rocket. There it is. And we had already finished all the science I was going to do at the moon. If I zoom in here on the rocket. There it is. Old Valentino there has already had a spacewalk. We've already opened our science bay. There it is there. And I did some goo as well. So I've got plenty of science from moon orbit. We weren't able to land. As you see, this rocket is not really designed for landing. This middle section here, these fuel tanks, are the fuel we needed to get to the moon and get back from the moon. Looks like we still have 1/3 left, so we're doing pretty well. And then when we get back to Kerbal orbit, we're going to break it off here, get rid of these fuel tanks, and just have the lander and the science equipment land again. How are we doing here? 11 minutes, alright. So you see which way the rocket's pointed? There's a beautiful shot of the moon. Come around the bright side, that means there's a star behind us. There it is. So as we come around this side of the moon, we're going to start accelerating. Not just yet, we still have 8 minutes. I'm just going to try and point the blue a little better. It's down here. Yeah, there we go. So estimates we're going to do 14 second engine burn. I'm going to do it in 7 minutes, so speed up time again. Do it a little faster. But we're no longer going to be orbiting the moon. Well, that was our planned trajectory. The blue one is our actual trajectory, so we went a little bit too fast. And then purple is our planned trajectory in relation to Kerbal. And orange is our actual directory, so trajectory. So it looks like we're going to be fine. In fact, we came out a little bit better. 2.6 million. We're going to get there in a day. So of course we don't want to wait a day. So we're going to speed up time again. And see if you can watch what our spacecraft does. There we go, a little faster. Starting to see some movement, a little more faster. There we go, see the spacecraft moving? See if you can understand what it does in relation to the moon and Kerbal, and you'll see how these two things come together. Here's spacecraft. Since we're going quicker now, we're leaving. There it is there, see? We're leaving. We're going too fast for the moon. It can't hold us anymore. The gravity is not strong enough. The gravity is very small for this moon. And we're leaving it. We're heading off into space. You see, as the moon leaves us, or as we leave it, I suppose. And there's Kerbal. The moon is going to go around Kerbal. We are also going around Kerbal. And you see what's happening now. We're getting closer to where it says we're going to be in relation to Kerbal. The moon is no longer holding on to us. There's not enough gravity in this moon to hold on to us. Kerbal has been pulling on us the whole time. Now that the moon cannot pull on us anymore, because we're too far from that little tiny thing, the gravity of Kerbal is going to be holding on to us. So even though we're zooming this direction, Kerbal's going to pull us, and it's going to bend our zooming around. And around. Farther from the moon, we're still all going in this direction. And there we go. So it looks like our maneuver, we're still going this way fast, but here we go, around in a Kerbal orbit. Now, the periapsis is way over here. Oh. Okay, our periapsis, oh, I see, it changed frames of reference for the moon. Okay. Our periapsis is way over here, where is it? Ooh, there it is. At 2.6 million. So that's our closest approach to Kerbin. Still pretty far. But if we want to get closer to Kerbin, to Kerbal, we are going to do a maneuver at this point, at a periapsis point. So we're going to add a maneuver over here. Look at all the complex stuff that tells us. Look. If we didn't do anything, we didn't zoop zoop, we didn't count to the moon again. We don't want that. So where is our let's get rid of this moon. It's just confusing. So, the periapsis, we're gonna do a maneuver. What we're going to do is we're going to slow down, which means we're gonna go in retrograde. This is looking down on it now. So as we come around here, I'm going to slow down time so I can talk. As we come around to here, we're going to be heading this direction. We're going to slow down our spacecraft so it gets slow. It doesn't go as far, and Kerbal is going to pull us. Zoom, 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 zoom. So to do that, we want to accelerate in this direction. And look, our planned trajectory is getting smaller. Gentle with the controls and make our planned trajectory much smaller. Now that's going to be a big burn for us. So we're going to get ourselves down here to low orbit and then we'll move this to see. Look, we do. If we do our burn over here, the same amount of burn. Hey, where'd it go? Alright, make a new one. If we do our burn over here, we have to burn less. Well, that's good to know. So let's do that. Let's get ourselves over here. I wonder then, if we go this way, do we have to burn even less? Oh, we do. Oh, that's gonna make us hit Kerbal. Not good. Let's see, that's 100 kilometers above Earth, above Kerbal. That's pretty good. But look, a very eccentric orbit. That means if we only do this one burn, we're going to follow this brown line. Way out from Kerbal, way into Kerbal, way out from Kerbal, way into Kerbal. I wonder if we can skip off the atmosphere and slow ourselves down. We better be careful with this. Let's go into a less weird orbit. Let's try this one. So we're going to reduce our speed. Okay, that's done in 3 game hours. So, remember, this is only just planning, so we have to actually do it. So we come down here. And I can't see it to move. They're on the ship. What's happening? Let's zoom in. Nothing's happening. There we go. That was in time mark. Okay, so we're looking for not that marker. These are different types of markers that we saw on the orbital map. We'll go from there, you can see in the different directions. Always relative to your orbit. We want to go to the blue one, the dark blue one. This is our planned trajectory. The direction we want to face for our burn. There we go, so we're just about lined up. So, you see what's happened. We're pointing very much away from Kerbal right now to help us slow down. So, in 3 hours, we're going to burn for about 30 seconds. So let's crank up the time warp and let's get there. You'll see as we go around Kerbal, our direction of our spacecraft doesn't actually change, although it does change in relation to Kerbal. 2 hours, 2.5, 1.5. There goes Kerbal over there. 50 minutes, let's slow down time a little bit. 35, 34. So you see what we're going to do. We're going that way, so we're going to burn against that direction. 23 minutes. Slow down time dilation again. 3, 2, slow down again. And we have a 30 second burn, so we're going to start a little bit early to make sure that we get it right. But to burn, we have to be down at zero speed, at zero time dilation. So we're going to drop again. There we go. Didn't look like we did too much, but you see that we're not zipping past that planet anymore. We're kind of just hanging here. And the gravity of Kerbal is going to pull us towards Kerbal. We can see that on the map now. Our new trajectory is going to pull us towards Kerbal. We're going to zip around it and come back out here. That's okay. When we get to our closest point, or near our closest point, we're going to do another maneuver. That's not right. Let's get rid of some of these extra maneuvers here, because they're just polluting it. So somewhere about here, we're going to add a maneuver, and again, we're going to slow the spaceship down somewhere. Let's move this around. Get a little more circular of an orbit. Okay, our closest approach here, 300,000, so we're still not that close to Kerbal. A little more circular. 300,000 is our closest approach. I want to drop that down quite a bit. We can zoom in here for a second. 180. That's getting pretty close. Incredible. That'll put us in much more of a circular orbit. That's a good thing for us. So let's get our spaceship ready for that maneuver. I'm going to aim him at the new maneuver node. We look like this, we're still in a flat plane. There. There's the moon way over there. And now, if I do nothing, Kerbal has us in its grip. We want that though. We want to slow down and we'll land on Kerbal. So, where do we go right here? Oh, there it is. All aimed up. Okay, and then we can do a. I thought we can do a warp too. Well, we'll manually warp for 1 hour. We'll speed up time. We may have noticed there is another spaceship orbiting Kerbal. This poor astronaut has run out of fuel and is stuck in orbit. I think later in the game we might be able to rescue that astronaut. And there is also, I'll have to zoom way out, some poor sucker. That's Kerbal. That's the moon. Here's Mimas. It's another moon of Kerbal. And if I zoom out far enough, there we go. It's Kerbal and all its moons orbit around the sun, which I don't know the name of yet. But lost in space, right here, is astronaut Eve. We launched from Kerbal. Zoom in a bit. And I was heading for the moon, just there, but I went so fast that she went, well, right past the moon. And once she got out here, Kerbal's gravity wasn't enough to bring her back. So she just kept sailing off into space, sailing off into space. And she was heading like this, and then as she was sailing, like this, she was sailing this way, then the power of that sun pulled her around, and then went around. So now she's orbiting around this poor sun, nowhere near the planet Kerbal. She's near some of these other planets. It looks like there's Kerbin, and it comes around, and it looks like she does cross the path of Kerbin. In the plane of Kerbin? Yes, in the plane of Kerbin. She does cross the path of Kerbin every now and then. And so I think, again, later, at the right time, we might be able to get a rescue mission for her. But for right now, she's lost. Okay, so I slowed down time, so we're not approaching as fast as we should. So I'm going to speed time up. And let's get our spaceship towards that maneuver node. 1 hour, 5 minutes. Zoom. Here we go. Okay. Okay, we'll speed up our time. What do we have? 6 minutes. 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's start our burn now. Orbit is reducing. We're gonna try and get down to this planned orbit. This is our apoaxis, the farthest point. Right now we're at periaxis, the closest point. And that's why we're doing the maneuver over here, slow ourselves down, and we'll reduce. It changes the other side of the orbit by the most. You see the sides are changing too, but the most change happens in the opposite side of the orbit. And you look, the periaxis, our closest approach, is moving. Go to the other side as we slow down. That's pretty good. That's good. We don't know what too far we're going to get in the atmosphere. Ooh, 95, that's pretty far. Zoom in a bit. Okay. Center on Kerbal, or Kerbin, instead of the spaceship. And we'll move this maneuver node since we don't need it anymore. So you see the two spaceships. There's this spaceship that's lost, the gray one. We're not worrying about that right now. Here's us. At our highest point, 510 meters. At our lowest point, 95,000 meters. Pretty close to the atmosphere. When we get to our lowest point, just before it, another maneuver, another slowdown. And you see, we want to watch our lowest point, periapsis, 70,000. We want to be careful. We want to get towards the atmosphere, but not so low that we burn up. Although, maybe we'll just do the landing. What will happen if we just do our landing? I wonder if I have enough fuel to just land this thing. Let's try this. Let's burn up all our fuel at that point. Slow ourselves down. Come to a landing. I think so. I think we have plenty of fuel. Yeah, not so much. Well, I have to get to work soon, so we're just going to have to land this thing. or not landed. That poor astronaut will just die. After orbiting the moon and doing so much science for us, he's gonna burn up on his way into Kerbal. Kerbal has an atmosphere, you see, so going through the air at high speeds causes friction. Okay, right, and friction causes heat. So where's Kerbal? Oh, there's Kerbal, Kerbin, and that is very dark. So 18 minutes, we're going to do a long burn. So let's speed this up as we go around the planet. Oh, I think we're going to land on the day side. That'll be nice. Camera. There's the moon in the background. We were over there, but now we're landing here. Okay. 3 minutes. 2 minutes. 1 minute. So we're going to slow down time again. So in 1 minute, we're going to do a 43-second burn. Again, I start them a little bit early. And that should put us down somewhere in this big continent that's showing up. Well, this will be exciting. Alright, let's crank on our engines. This here is our speed on the planet. See, it's going down. As we know, we're zipping around the planet. And when you zip around, we're always falling towards the planet. Since when it's round, it disappears underneath you. And as you keep zipping around, you keep falling. In this case, it even zips faster. So I'm still falling towards the planet. See that on top of the planet, it's still changing. Oh, that's it. We ran out of fuel. So, was that enough? We can tell by looking at the map. It was enough. Our planned trajectory will bring us down to Kerbin. You see that? Our maneuver node is done with now because... get rid of it. Because we have no fuel left, so we cannot maneuver anymore. But look, our planned trajectory will land us on Kerbin right there. So we're going to land right there, which is nowhere near the spaceport. The spaceport is on this continent over here somewhere. That must be on this side of it. So we're going to land on the other side of the planet. But that's okay. We're still going to land. So, we have no fuel left. This engine is out, and I have no other engines. So we're going to get rid of it. Goodbye, engine. Thank you for taking us to the moon. There it goes. So, what does that leave us with? It leaves us with a trajectory that is going to hit the planet. You see our altitude is dropping. And we have a space capsule. Now, luckily, I did put a heat shield on the bottom of this thing, expecting that we were going to come in hard. Which it looks like we are. So, you can see the direction that we're heading. So what we're going to do is we're going to tilt the spacecraft. There we go. To point the heat shield most at the direction that the heat's going to come. And hopefully we're going to get through the atmosphere. And then I have 3 parachutes on this thing. Hopefully they don't burn up on re-entry. Because I have 3 parachutes, because one parachute can handle this crew module. But then I also have a science storage container here and a science chamber. So there's a lot of weight on this machine. And in a short while here, 80,000 meters, in a short while, we're going to hit the atmosphere. That's the air around Kerbin. And we are screaming along here at 2,000 meters per second. That's 2 kilometers every second. So we are just screaming along, although it looks very peaceful from up here. Once we hit that atmosphere, you will see that we're going to start to burn up. Oh, there goes the space music, so it's time. And I don't know if this spaceship is going to survive or if we're going too fast. I think we're going to survive. But it's going to be a fiery re-entry. Meters. quiet and peaceful. As soon as we start hitting the air, I guess that happens when this atmosphere pointer reaches the blue, right? I guess that must be when the air starts. Oh boy. We're still going extremely fast. In fact, we're speeding up here. As we start to fall to Earth, we're speeding up. I'm worried that we're going too fast. I needed a little more fuel. Or I need it to be a little more efficient. Oh, here we go. It's go time. Let's hope that heat shield is doing its job. Oh boy. That was a little fun. But look, our speed is dropping. That's good. Our speed is dropping. Oh no. That gets damaged. Our science junior. That looks like our heat shield. Yeah, that's our heat shield. That's our science junior. That's our storage bay. Oh, we lost a battery pack. That's no problem. There's one battery pack there. And we lost the battery pack. Psh. Who cares? It looks like we almost lost two battery packs. That one's damaged. It's burning up. Alright. So now we are going a much more reasonable 180 meters per second. I can almost turn us around. Here we go. 6,000 meters above the planet, and we're going to land in a desert. But it looks like our chutes are not actually destroyed. So let's pop out our chutes now, 3,000 kilometers above. There they go, it looks like they're good. They will not open. There's the moon in the background, how beautiful. That's where we were. Above Earth, 1,500 meters above Earth, and we're falling at a very comfortable 50 meters per second. That will slow right down once those parachutes deploy at 500 meters. Okay, 700 meters, whatever. There they go, and we've slowed right down to 4 meters per second. That's about a running speed for an adult. Maybe a pretty fast run. Okay, so we're coming down. 600, 500, I'll speed up time a bit because I don't want to wait. Four hundred meters. And it's slow down because sometimes that's above sea level, and if we land on a mountain, definitely in the desert. We did it. We totally landed. Alright, let's recover our vessel. That is completely awesome. That was my first ever successful moon orbit. As you saw, the last two astronauts ended up all over space. Okay, look at all that science we got. 116 science earned for that trip. That's fantastic. We did not get back very much of the funds from the trip, 3,000, because we lost a lot on the way. And Valentina got 3 experience points. Fantastic. Oh, some debris can recover some of this stuff. That's great. Well, I don't know how to recover that stuff. Maybe we already recovered it. There we go, now we recovered it. Okay, so, first successful moon landing. Fantastic, I'm gonna have to save the game here. And head off to work. Thank you for watching.